And hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Before we do get into today's video, as always, make sure you do drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel for more Celtic content. So I hope you guys are all well. As you can tell by the title, we've got a little bit of an update for you with the transfer of Balakwisha to Celtic, the Royal Antwerp right winger. He's of course been linked to the club for the last 2 weeks now. We first found out about the interest in him about 2 weeks ago. Things have kind of accelerated quite slowly towards maybe getting that transfer over the line in the next few weeks. We have a little bit of an update with regards to that transfer story in today's video. It is a positive update as well, which is good to see. But before I do get into the main story, there's two other mini stories I want to go over quickly. We'll start with Cinciarlo, the new goalkeeper that we signed. Of course, we've seen what he's kind of capable of yesterday when we took on DC United and won the game 4-0. He came on at the break and made his first appearance for the club. And to be honest, I thought he was okay. He looked quite competent with his feet. He looked pretty comfortable on the ball when the ball was at his feet. Of course, he's not the finished product just yet. He's still really young for a goalkeeper, especially. He's only 22 years old. But he spoke to the media after the game and he gave us an insight on his kind of thought process behind his move to Celtic and what kind of persuaded him to go up country or out the country to Scotland and leave Aston Villa, the club that he's been at since he was 16. And the man that was key to that move was former Hibernian player and massive Celtic fan, John McGinn. So what Cinciarlo said in the interview was, I spoke to him a lot about moving up to Scotland. John said to me I should jump at this chance. He gave us a little bit of advice, which I won't tell. So John McGinn's kind of a little bit of an agent for us, I suppose, persuading players to come up to Celtic. He's a player that I'd love to see play for us in a few years' time, of course. He's still very much, you know, doing bits for Aston Villa right now. He's a captain. They're playing Champions League football in the Premier League. They're doing really great stuff under Unai Emery. But in a few years' time, I'd love to see him come play for Celtic. Of course, he is a massive Celtic fan. His idol was Henrik Larsson growing up. That's who he idolised when he was a young player, going for the youth setup through Scotland. So definitely a player I want to see come up to the club in the future. But back to Cinciarlo, it's quite interesting to see that he spoke to John McGinn. He obviously knew that his kind of connection to Celtic and what he thinks of the club. And that definitely persuaded him in his move up to Scotland. But let's talk about another player that played yesterday and a player that I'm kind of torn between on opinions of what to do with him. He's a player that's kind of divided fans' opinions, I suppose, if you will, in the last few seasons. That is Mikey Johnson, of course. He spent last season out alone at West Bromwich Albion, had a great campaign for them, and he became somewhat of a fan favourite down there for West Brom. A lot of the fans at West Brom wanted to sign him permanently after his brilliant, you know, time there on loan. But from a Celtic point of view, I'm a little bit torn between what I want to do with Mikey Johnson, because he came on at half-time yesterday, he scored a goal, which is great, but other than that, he looked pretty poor, I thought. I mean, he missed his penalty, which is fair enough. You miss some, you score some. But there was other parts of his match throughout the friendly yesterday, I thought, it kind of summarises Celtic career in terms of being inconsistent. He comes on, he scores a goal, but then he kind of goes ghost for the rest of the match and kind of performs quite badly. There was an instance where he crossed the ball and it went to row Z. Little things like that, it kind of makes my opinion a little bit, you know, a bit 50-50 what I want to do with him. Do we sell him? Do we keep him? So I want to ask your opinion on this situation. Given the fact he is, of course, a Celtic fan, he came from the youth setup, he loves the club, he's a homegrown player, that's kind of making me want to keep him at the club and try and give him another chance. But he's 25 years old now, he's not a young player anymore, he's kind of reaching his peak, if you will, he's getting close to his peak age of a footballer, which is like 26, 27. And I'm trying to think, is there any point giving him another chance at Celtic? Because there seems to be a bit of a stumbling block for him when he plays in the hoops. He's like, he's so inconsistent that sometimes you look at him and he's a really good player, then sometimes he's just absolutely piss poor. And yesterday's cameo, the 45 minutes he played, he kind of summarised his Celtic career as a whole, I thought, scoring the goal then being pretty poor throughout the rest of the game. So the question for you today is, do we sell Mikey Johnson or do we keep him? Let me know your opinions on that one down below in the comment section. Now, a transfer that could potentially make way, well, could persuade Mikey Johnson to leave the club is if we get Balakwisha from Antwerp. Of course, he plays in a similar position to Mikey Johnson. And this guy's been linked to us for about 2 weeks now, as I mentioned at the start of the video. And it's been reported that we made contact with him previously. And today, a Belgian journalist came out, Sasha Tavioli, stated on X that Brendan Rodgers has talked with Balakwisha, but that his agent has contacted Stade Rennais about the availability of his services. So Rodgers has spoke directly to the player, trying to persuade him to come to Celtic, but his agent has actually spoke to Stade Rennais about his availability also. So that could maybe spike a little bit of a bidding war for the player if they are interested in him. Now, for me personally, looking at his stats alone, I've never actually watched him play a live match. Of course, I'm not a massive Belgian football fan, but his stats are really good. I said the other day, I think it was yesterday, that he's got like 10 goals and 5 assists in like 30 games last season, which is a goal contribution every 2 matches, which is a really good return. And of course, if we are interested in him, he must be a pretty good player. And the right wing position in our team isn't solidified by any individual player right now. Of course, Palmer has played there quite a lot last season. Again, similar to Mikey Johnson, we've just discussed, quite inconsistent at times as well. And of course, Yang played there a few times as well. And he had a few games that he was all right at, but he was not definitely at a Celtic level. So I think Balakwisha could come into the team and definitely improve that position for sure. The transfer fee for him has not really been mentioned whatsoever online. I wouldn't really know what we'd have to pay to get him in through the door. But if we look at our transfers so far, we've been pretty shrewd with our spending. Look, Kasper Schmeichel was a free transfer. It's kind of expected. He's 37 years old. Cinciala was £1 million from Aston Villa. Pretty cheap for a young, promising goalkeeper. And of course, the Paolo Bernardo situation, which is ongoing, that's reported to be about £3.35 million, which is, again, it's still pretty cheap. We've got a large transfer kitty to spend. So I guess depending on how much this guy would cost, I think anything around £5 million would probably be worth it for him. But looking at his stats alone, I think he could be a good signing and definitely an improvement on what we've got in that area of the pitch already. But I want to know your thoughts on that, because that basically states that report that Rodgers has actually contacted the player directly, trying to persuade him, which I'd love to see. I'd love to see the manager getting stuck in and trying to get the players that he wants into his team by directly speaking to them. It shows a bit of intention behind one of the players that he wants, which is quite cool to see. But regardless of those signings that we mentioned previously, there's still areas in the park we need to improve on. We want to get another striker in. We need a left back. We need 2 more centre backs. There's still a lot to happen in the transfer window, and we'll keep you guys updated throughout this transfer window as well, because it'll be very busy for Celtic this next few weeks for sure. But as always, let me know your thoughts down below on what we mentioned in today's video. Make sure you do drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel for more Celtic content. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.